The All-American Half Pound. Sweet pure beef patty. Lettuce, tomato.
Singles. Going.
Begin bombing in 5 minutes.
What? This is Singles Going Steady, the podcast dedicated to exploring great singles with a particular eye to the punk, new wave, what, and DIY eras of the last century. My name is Steve McGowan.
And I'm a little bit punch drunk too, and I'm also Adrienne Meddock. We're in a band, The Beef People, who released a single in 1986 on our own label, Zub Records. But we're also record collectors and passionate, especially about the expression of pop music perfection that is the single recording. Exploring the mystery of what makes for a great single is what propelled us to begin this podcast. And we're up to episode...
Number Singles Going Steady, 075.
075. Boy, you know, the odometer is flipping over.
It is just, we're burning through it.
We are. But hold up and savor the flavor.
Yes.
That is... Captain Sensible.
What?
And yes, the remarkable single What.
Yes, it is. It's even for us two wordy people, this one's going to be hard to explain.
Yeah, you just have to listen, and I people find meaning in this song, and you'll find your own meaning.
That's right.
And what? But what we can tell you about it, we've talked mm-hmm. about The Damned, and we right. talked a little bit about Captain Sensible, I think, in our New mm-hmm. Rose podcast.
Right. He's a founding member of The Damned.
Right, started as the bass player right. and then switched over to guitar.
Right, after Brian James left.
And so this is an early 80s, 82
yeah.
or so.
This was a period where he had left the band, left The Damned, and was doing a solo career.
As you do.
And would go back in the 90s to join The Damned again. But he did pretty well with his solo career.
Yeah.
And did you know he did some stuff with Robin Hitchcock as well?
No, we yeah, talked in a recent podcast about how Robin was a great collaborator. Mm-hmm. And yeah, mm-hmm. and of course.
Robin played on Happy Talk.
Ah, and Happy Talk, I think, was the
single this one.
The lead single his mm-hmm. From this album, mm-hmm. His solo album. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, the Watt sort of captured Happy Talk mm-hmm. cover, right?
Yeah.
And you've got, here you've got, I was going to say an original, but I mean, it's an original with a heavy emphasis on original. It's like a 12-inch dance monster type of single.
It turned out to be a dance hit in both the UK and the US.
Wherever people mm-hmm. dance, right?
Right. Mm-hmm.
So it's really especially single when it came to the U.S. I mean, it was not, you know, a broadly popular song. But
wasn't on MTV, as far as I remember.
But as far as the dance halls go, mm-hmm. WAP came on and people hopped.
Yep. So, Captain Sensible from The Damned, just being his zany, crazy self.
Yeah, this is just...
doing his thing. Just letting his freak flag fly.
Right, you know, mm-hmm. and letting us all dance along to it. Mm-hmm. And, well, let's play a little bit.
What? Okay, Captain, here we go. This is from 1982. It's on A&M Records. And it is Captain Sensible with What?
this morning I was feeling fine, but this cat starts banging, man, what a swine. So I called reception, but to no avail. That's why I'm telling you this sorry tale. It went bang, I said shut up. It went bang, I said wrap up. Well, I'm aware that the guy must do his work, but the paunch of a man drove me berserk. He said, Captain, I said what? He said, Captain, I said what? The west, where the girls are like most are the ones undressed. Well, hello, Adam, where you been? I said, stand aside, cause I'm a feeling mean. I had a gut full of you and I'm a feeling bad, but you're an ugly old pirate and ain't I glad? He said, Captain, I said, what? He said, Captain, I said, what? He said, Captain, I said, what? He said, Captain, I said, what you want? I said what? He said Captain. I said what? He said Captain. I said what? He said Captain. I said what you want?
So here we've got this solo effort, and this was, you know, sort of the mid-80s. You had a couple folks splintering off from the original groups. And, you know, I'd originally we floated the notion of having sort of like the wayward bassist as a theme. And I was thinking, well, we would have this single. Mm-hmm. We could also have Didi Ramone spinning off to his rap career as Didi King. And, you know, you could probably put Tina Weymouth Tom Tom Club in there as well.
This is not completely dissimilar to Tom Tom Club. It's got that danceability.
But I think the thing that they have in common is that they all, you know, despite sort of the superficial commonalities, is that you've got folks trying to branch off into other types of music, maybe even more sort of appealing, mass appeal.
More commercial.
Or more commercial, that's the word.
Compared to the Damned, you know, I mean, the Damned in the later stages certainly started to get more of a pop edge to them.
Yeah, and you've
got... But they're still the Damned.
Right. You know? But you've got Sensible, and you've got Tom Tom Club finding great, you know, huge
success. It's not
success.
Psycho Killer, you know.
Yeah, huge success on, as dance records. I don't think Didi King...
Was particularly successful at anything.
Rest his soul.
Again, the Watt single, it's got that... It's basically the Good Times bass line, the chic Good Times bass line played sideways, like any good dance song of the era did do, or rap song, you know. Everybody stole the bass line one way or the other. You had to have it. I mean, it was de rigueur. And he puts it to good use.
But you've got these zany, wacky lyrics.
Yeah, yabo lyrics.
Yeah, so, you know, it's the sort of thing that makes you sort of, if you're driving, you know, maybe veer into something, because it's just like, what is that?
Yeah.
Or what is that? And, we've talked before about how much the series Legion, Noah Hawley's Legion.
This is a big thing for us.
Right, and just being enamored with Legion, and you just think it can't get any more sort of niche and specialized in speaking directly to your to you. Mm-hmm. Except in the, you know, we're building towards the climax of the series.
Right, season three.
And we're getting ready to meet, you know, this important Marvel character, Professor X, the father of
Charles
Legion,
Xavier.
Right? And so what starts playing?
Yes.
It's that bass line.
First it's faint and you're not really sure what it is.
And you're like, that sure sounds like... Captain.
Yeah.
And it was.
By the end of the show, it's you know, up all the way, and said Captain. I said, what?
It was like, what?
It's like, I think my head is spinning.
Yeah. So what a strange thing to pick. It was anachronistic. It was something that was set in World War II era.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, the episode was. Mm-hmm. And you know, what's your rationale for why they... Why they selected that? I mean, the music choices were always spectacular.
I know,
on that show.
You know, I remember the first time we were watching it, and you were like, "Listen to this," and it was the Banana Splits theme, and I was like, "Oh, somebody's got my number."
Yep.
You know, I mean, it's like he gets it. You know, and there was more than one occasion in that show where the music would come through. I mean, what was David Holler. Didn't he sing Peace, Love, and Understanding?
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, I mean,
he did. Yeah, so it's...
I mean, it's like we curated the playlist,
right?
You know?
Yeah, right, my subconscious,
right.
I think. It must have been it's something on the astral plane, I think.
Right, yeah.
You know, our souls were communing or whatever with Noah Hawley.
Yeah.
But...
he's got our number.
But
I mean,
you've got that bass line, that insistent, that catchiness, that the sort of... skewed, like,
weird lyric that you can't really like put your finger on why he's using it for this scene.
Right, but it does, I think, because there's not a lot of inherent meaning in it, and it's not gibberish.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that it's got a slightly menacing character to
keep you thinking.
Yeah. So it was sort of off-putting, off-kilter.
Mm-hmm.
So perhaps that was why it was selected. Maybe you know.
So again, we are talking about the FX series called Legion.
Legion.
That
yeah.
was done by Noah Hawley, who did Fargo. Who's doing Fargo? And
I mean, just spectacular. It's one of the finest things I think I've seen on TV ever.
It's not on now. I'm sure you can stream it. I'm sure you can find it. It's not currently airing anymore. They did three seasons.
The series is completed. The arc is completed.
And it was a Marvel Comics thing, which is something Adrienne and I would never be interested in. Neither are comic book people.
Not denigrating, but we're,
it's
just not my thing.
It's not our thing, you know.
But this was my thing.
This particular series... everything about it, especially the visuals, the music.
Especially the everything.
The music,
the
musical
the performances,
numbers.
The casting, everything was perfect.
And it's just out there, and it's just a wild ride of a TV show, and I don't think either of us can recommend it enough. So I was going on and on about it. If you hadn't seen it, you know, you really probably want to check it out. Irregardless, this is still a great... cool little single.
Yeah, it's a great single.
Yeah.
It's it's fun, it's weird. It's sort of inexplicable, and
yes.
I think either it catches you sort of subconsciously and sucks you in, or maybe it's not for you. But
right.
You know, it, like a great single, I think it elicits strong responses.
Mm-hmm. Right. Exactly. Well, we got a lot out on that one, didn't we?
Yeah. Who could you hear covering this?
Well, I'm gonna go straight to Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five.
Oh,
you know, it's the same bass line.
Oh yeah.
I'd like to hear them.
Child is born in a state of mind. What?
Wrap it out. Yeah. It would be weird, but it would be fun.
It would. But like, you know, I was thinking of was Kid Creole.
Oh yes,
because you got the coconuts, right?
Yes,
so to get the backing
get
vocals,
get the cool backing single.
Yeah,
backing,
so I was thinking in keeping the dance and
the party going
and the pop, maybe get it a little less.
Get a little Latin drums in there.
Yeah,
it would be a yes.
So yeah, that would be.
I think that's an excellent choice.
All right, so that's our Who would cover? Do you have any recommendations for
people? Well, I think we're going to go over some stuff we may have already recommended. You know, obviously Legion. Yeah. We're both going to recommend Legion. And I believe during the Damned podcast, I recommended the video documentary about the Damned. It's called Don't You Wish That We Were Dead. And it's fairly recent. Shows the band playing, the whole history of the band. Everybody who's been in the band is in it. Captain Sensible is amazing in it. He's funny as hell. He can't keep his pants on.
And I just wanted to holler out. I was just thinking about Captain being at the Pete Shelley Memorial Concert.
Yes,
mm-hmm. You know, and you know he came out in this big fur coat.
I know with, like, he did the whole like thing.
With a canvas bag. That he was pulling stuff out right. of. I mean he. He's got that clown.
Yeah, he's got that English thing. That, right. You know, I'm here to entertain you.
Yeah,
you know.
I'm out of the dance hall right. kind of heritage.
It's like, where's me washboard?
Yeah, musical. Yeah, yeah, Arthur Atkinson. Right. So maybe that'll be my recommendation again, mm-hmm. which would be the FAF show.
Yes.
Shown in the United States as brilliant.
We were watching it the other night and laughing.
Right. So
a lot of it is very politically incorrect, but we were laughing.
Yeah, it's kind of shocking. The Brits are a little more
less correct
to begin with, and then you mm-hmm. put it back in time 25 yeah. years and there's some ouch moments.
It's just like, wow, I can't believe they said that.
But what's funny is funny.
Yes, it is. So we have a lot of maybe retreaded recommendations, but they're all good recommendations.
Yeah, we still stand by them.
Yes, we do. So there we go. A bit of fun, Captain.
Yeah, with a little bit of a Heart of Darkness menace there as a Noah Hawley sort of unveiled for mm-hmm. us.
Captain Sensible, what? 1982. A&M Records. Lots of fun. We're having a good time with the Captain. And anything else?
No, I think that we've recommended enough.
Okay. Well, we will talk to you very soon, and thanks for listening with us.
Bye.
Bye now.
To learn more about the artists and recordings we just talked about, visit our website at zubrecords.com and click on the Singles Going Steady icon.
You'll also find links to the persons, places, and things we recommend, and much more.
You can find episodes of Singles Going Steady on our website or wherever you get your favorite podcasts.
Singles Going Steady is brought to you by the power and majesty of Zub Records.
Zub Records. Smart sounds for sharp people.